Let's see 21. Read all elements from an array in the reverse direction. Read all elements from an array. Read all elements from an array in the reverse direction. Only reading the elements in the reverse direction. Array content reading in the reverse direction. First you have to read the 12, then 9, then 6, then 4, then 10. Array content remains the same. We are just reading in the reverse order. Array content remains the same. We are not changing array content. We are not changing array content. We are reading array content in the reverse order. We are reading array content in the reverse order. Start with the 12, read it, then 9, then 6, then 4, then 10. Likewise, array content we are reading in the reverse direction. The last element index is length minus 1. Whatever it may be the last element, that last element index is length minus 1. I is initializing with length minus 1. I is initializing with length minus 1. Printing the last element. Then going to the next iteration, I is decrementing. I is decrementing. Initially I value, initially I value 7. 7 is becoming 6. 6 is greater than or equal to 0. Printing 9. Then I value becoming 5. 5 is greater than or equal to 6. Greater than or equal to 0. Then 6 is printing. I is keep decrementing. I is keep decrementing. Save it as a u.java. Let's compile it. I'm printing in the same line by using comma as a separator. We are not reversing array content. Array content remains the same. While reading array content, we are reading in the reverse order. We are reading in the reverse order. Come to the next one. Read first half of the elements in the reverse direction. Read the first half of the array in the reverse direction. Assume array content, array containing even number of elements. Total number of elements are even, equally balanced. If it is odd, then you have to find out middle element, will it be coming under first or under second. Consider straight away array containing even number of elements. Even number of elements, then we have to read first half. Starting from 0, even number of elements. Total number of elements are 8. X dot length divided by 2. x dot length divided by 2 is of 4, I less than 4. So I values 0, 1, 2, 3. 0 is allowed, 1 also, 2 also, 3. Whenever I is becoming 4, it is coming away. We have to read first half of the elements and we are assuming total number of elements are even. If total number of elements are odd, then middle element, it may become in the first half or it may become in the second half. Consider even number of elements. In the last class, we have seen odd number of elements also. Compile and run. Total number of elements are 8. 8 divided by 2 is a 4. Indexes allowing are 0, 1, 2, 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. Totally 4 elements in the same line, straight forward, it's very simple. Indexes are starting from 0. Middle element index is length divided by 2 minus 1. Length divided by 2 minus 1. Copy the same. What is that? We wanted in the reverse order. Yes. Reading first half of the elements in the reverse order. Start I value, length by 2 minus 1, length is 8, 8 by 2 4, 4 minus 1 3, I is starting from 3, every time I is decrementing, reaching I value till to 0. స్టార్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద మిడిల్ కీప్ రీడింగ్ టిల్ టు ద ఫస్ట్ ఫస్ట్ హాఫ్ ఆఫ్ ద అర్రే ఇన్ ద రివర్స్ ఆర్డర్ స్టార్టింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద మిడిల్ దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఇండెక్స్ ఆఫ్ మిడిల్ ఎలిమెంట్ ఐ ఈస్ ఇనిషియలైజింగ్ విత్ ఇండెక్స్ ఆఫ్ మిడిల్ ఎలిమెంట్ రీడ్ దట్ మిడిల్ ఎలిమెంట్ డిక్రిమెంట్ కీప్ కంటిన్యూ టిల్ టు ఐ వాల్యూ జీరో కాపీ ద సేమ్ Read second half of the elements in the reverse direction. Second half of the elements in the reverse direction. Second half of the array, reading in the reverse direction. I am considering same array with even number of elements. Even number of elements. Total number of elements are even. Second half of the array. Second half of the array in the reverse direction. I should start with length minus 1. I should start with length minus 1. I greater than or equal to. Divided by 2 second half of array second half of the array Starting from the last index, keep decrementing every time, keep decrementing. It's a straightforward. You should know from which index you have to read till to which index. Arrays are manipulating through indexes. You should have a clear idea about the indexes. Come to the next one.
read only even indexed elements from an array. Read only even indexed elements from an array. Read only even indexed elements from an array. Start from 0. It's already 0. Read only even indexed elements from an array. You have to read 3, 1, 4, 9. Whichever elements is stored in the even indexes, whichever elements is stored in the even indexes, those elements we have to read. Whichever elements stored in the even indexes, those elements we have to read. Start from I value 0, read x of 0, increment I value 2. Then x of 2, increment I value to 4, x of 4, 6, as long as elements are there. Come to the next one. Read only even indexed elements from an array in the reverse direction. even indexed elements from the array in the reverse direction. If it is in the reverse direction, we don't know exactly whether last element is an even indexed one or odd indexed one. It is purely based on total number of elements. If total number of elements are even, then the last element index is an odd. If total number of elements are 8, last element index is a 7, which is an odd. If total number of elements are odd, assume total number of elements are 7, then last element index will be 6, which is an even. So whether last element you have to consider while reading only even indexed in the reverse direction. You need to check whether last element is an even indexed or odd indexed. It is purely based on total number of elements. If total number of elements are 8, index is starting from 0, so last element index is 7. If you want to read only even index, you need to check whether last element is a even index or odd index. If it is an even index, you have to stop. If it is odd index, you have to proceed the previous one. Let's go for int start or end. If x dot length mod 2, if x dot length mod 2 is 0, total number of elements are even. If total number of elements are even, the last element index is an odd. Last element index is an odd. You have to start last before 1. Otherwise, the last element itself. So please go through a ternary operator. If you have a if else condition only for assignment, if else condition only for assignment, then ternary operator is more advisable. I is starting with the end. Greater than or equal to 0. Every time decrement 2. Thank you.
total number of elements are even, extra length is a even, mod 2 remainder will be 0. If total number of elements are even, last element's index is a odd. Last index element is a odd. Don't consider last element. Go for last element to previous. If total number of elements are odd, consider 7. The last element index will be 6. We are considering last element is 6 only to start. It is purely based on whether total number of elements are even or odd. Total number of elements are even or odd. Nine, four, one, two. Come to the 26. Read only odd indexed elements. Odd indexed elements. Very simple. Starting from 1, every time incrementing 2. Starting from 1, every time incrementing 2. Read only odd indexed elements from and interpret. Starting from I value 1, every time I value incrementing 2. I less than x dot left. It will be starting from 6. Every time it will be incrementing 1. starting with 6, every time incrementing 1. This is simple. Next to 1. Read only odd indexed elements from an array in the reverse direction. You can copy Y class. Take the content of Y class. Make it as Z1. Read only odd indexed elements in the reverse direction. If total number of elements are even, the last index will be odd. If total number of elements are odd, then the last element will be even. You need to consider before last element. We need to read odd indexed elements in the reverse direction. Odd indexed elements in the reverse direction. If total number of elements are even, the last element is with the odd index. If total number of elements are odd, the last element is with even index because of indexes are starting from 0. because of indexes are starting from zero. In the last class itself, we have seen mod operator usage. If the remainder is zero, it returns true. When remainder will be zero, if total number of elements are even, if total number of elements are even, remainder will be zero, then the last element itself odd index, otherwise x dot length minus 2. Come to the next one. Find out an index of a specified element from a given array. Let me copy Z class. Z2. Find out an index of a specified element from a given array. Whatever element you have specified, that element's index you have to read. Any specified element, assume element is 10. What is its index? Let me choose initially index as minus 1. I want to find out where 10 is available in the 100. What is the index of 10? What should be the index of 10? Array already given, element also already given. You need to search for 10. What is the location where element is available? I is equal to 0. I less than x dot length. It is almost like a search. We are searching for a particular element. Mention element. Very simple logic. index is equal to I. If index is equal to element is available at specified index. Always advisable any negative number. Why? Because array indexes are starting from 0. If you take any positive number or 0, it might be available. You can go for any negative number, advisable minus. So here, practically we are coming to know importance of the break inside a for loop, inside a while loop, inside a do while loop, you can provide a break. After achieving whatever you wanted, assume you don't require further iterations, you can go for break. After identifying the element whichever you are searching, if that element is available, what is the need of? What is the need of searching further? So 3 is not a 10, 6 is not a 10, 1 is not a 10, 10 is a 10. So searching element is a 10, 10 is available, 10 is available. We found the element whichever we are searching, then specify index as a current I value, break it, no need of further iterations, no need of further iterations. So please observe, initially I am choosing index as a number which will not be having in any of the array. Array indexes are starting from 0, any positive number can be. If array contains 1000 elements, then till 999. So positive number you can expect in the array, but no array index will be the number. That is why initially I am choosing minus 1. Then I am comparing every element of the array, array elements, every array element, x of 0 is a 3, comparing with the 10, x of 1 is a 6, comparing with the 10, x of 1, sorry, x of 2 is a 1, comparing with the 10. X of 3, it is a 10. 10 is comparing with the 10. Going inside the block, we are modifying index value. Initially index was minus 1, now index will become a 3. We found like searching element is available at index number 3. Searching element is available at index number 3. Index is equal to 3. Then we don't require to go to index 4, index 5, index 6. Straight away break. So afterwards, we are checking whether index remains minus 1 or other than minus 1. If index remains minus 1, then whatever element you are searching, that is not available. If index is modified to any another number, then searching element is available. Element is available at a particular index. If at all index is remains minus 1, then else block will be executed. Verse is 28. No problem. Is available at index number 3. 10 is available at index number 3. Come to the 29. Swap two given indexed elements from the array. We need to swap two given indexed elements from the array. Swapping two indexed elements from the array swap two given indexed elements from the array. Thank you. let us consider, I want to swap I'll do the swapping here. Index number 3, index number 6. Try to swap these two elements. Here I and J both are indexes. Whichever element is available at 3 index, that element should be swapped with the 6. Index numbers are starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Index number 3 is a 10, index number 6 is a 9. 10 should be swapped with 9. So wherever 10 is there you have to keep 9. Wherever 9 is there you have to keep 10. Swapping two indexed elements. It's very simple. Let's go for one temp variable. Whatever value is there at x of I, that is x of 3, that is 10. 10 we are reading into temp. 10 we are reading into temp. Then, x of I is equal to x of j. X of j is equal to temp. By using one temporary variable, I am swapping the content. Whatever element available at index number 3, say we are swapping with index number 6. I is a 3, j is a 6. Use one temporary variable. Read x of I into the temp. Then assign x of j to the x of I. Then assign original temp to the x of j. By using one temporary variable, by using one temporary variable. Madam ji,
for in y equal to 0, in y equal to 0.
When I is equal to
the second to I is in the second time. V is equal
to I. So here we are using I. This will be available even for the loop also. Inside loop, once again, I. Let us go for this is other than. Let's go for Y and Z. Whatever index x containing, sorry, y containing and z containing, those indexed elements we are swapping two indexed elements we are swapping z3 initial array content, final array content. We know very well about println. Print and println. So please observe. Whatever element is there at 3 index, whatever element is there at 3 index, assigning to temp. Whatever element is there at 6 index, that is assigning to 3 index. Whatever you copied into the temp, that we are assigning to 6. We are assigning to 6. See, if we are confusing with x and z, we can provide 3 and 6 straight away. If you are confusing with x and y and z, you can go for 3, you can go for 6. Now remove y and z. Swapping one index value with other index value. Swapping one index value with other index. Almost like an exchange. Swapping one index value with other index. Most of the interviewers are asking, without a temporary variable, how you can swap? Without a temporary variable, try to swap without a temporary variable. Copy the same program. I'm choosing class name as Z3A. Without temporary variable, I want to swap index number 3 with index number 6. X of 3 is equal to x of 3 plus x of 6 then x of 6 is equal to x of 3 minus x of 6 x of 3 is equal to x of 3 is equal to correct or without temporary variable x of 3 is a 10, x of 6 is a 9. This value is a 90. So the current x of 3 is a 90. Ten plus 9 is equal to now x of 6 is equal to x of 3 90 minus x of 6 is 9 is equal to 10. X of 6 assigned with the 10. X of 6 assigned with the 10. But x of 3 remains 19 only. Now 19 minus 10. Only in case of numerics we can swap two values without third temporary variable we can able to swap. Initially add the sum to the x of 3, then x of 6 is equal to x of 3 is equal to this is the x of 3 this is x of 6 this is again x of 3 without temporary variable, how we can able to swap two values? Index number 3, we are swapping with index number 6. index number 3 we are swapping with index number 6. Simple calculation, a very simple, every standard student also can understand. Come to the next problem. Reverse the elements of given array. This is very important for the interviews. Reverse the elements of given array. Reversing content of the array. Earlier we have seen how to read the content of the array in the reverse direction, but the elements will be remains the same. In the earlier we have seen only reading in the reverse direction. We didn't modify the elements in the array in the reverse direction. Now permanently you have to modify the elements of the array into the reverse direction. You have to keep 12 at 3, 9 at 6, 6 at 1, likewise. The total content of the array, it should be modified. Earlier we have seen only reading of the array in the reverse direction. Now, we need to modify array content itself, reversing content of the array. So let us go for initial content as it is, final content. After reversing, we will print one more column. Reverse the elements of an array. Reverse it. For loop, int I is equal to 0. I less than divided by 2, I plus plus, by using temporary variable. Just to add this for loop, what we are doing here, please try to understand by yourself. Try to spend 5-10 minutes. This type of understanding is very important. It's very difficult. Check it out what we are doing. Initial for loop only for printing. The second for loop for reversing. The third for loop, after reversing we are printing. Please go through everybody, try to understand by yourself what is happening in the second for loop. Try to compose exactly as it is. So what we are doing? We are swapping first element with the last, first element with the last element, second element with the last but one. We already know how to swap. We already know how to swap. Swap 3 with 12, 12 will be coming at 0th index, 3 will be going to the 7th index. In the first iteration, I value 0, x of 0 is a 3, 3 is assigning to temp, 3 is assigning to temp. Then x of 0 is equal to x dot length minus I minus 1. Here length is 8, 8 minus 0 minus 1, that is 7. This will be resulting 12. X of 7 is a 12. In X of 0, that is in the 0th location, 12 is placing. Afterwards, X of 7 is equal to temp. Already temp is a 3. 3 is assigning in the last index. That is about first iteration. I repeat, if I value 0, x of 0, it is a 3, 3 assigning to temp. Temp value is 3. We are copying 3 into the temp. Then x of 0, that is x of 0 first index is equal to x of 8 minus 0 minus 1, that is 7. X of 7 is a 12. 12 is assigning to x of 0. 12 is assigning to x of 0. Then x of 7 is equal to temp. Temp is 3. That is about first iteration. In the second iteration, 6 should be swapped with 9. 6 should be swapped with 9. In the second iteration, I value 1, x of 1 assigning to temp. X of 1 assigning to temp. So temp value will be 6. Temp value will be 6. X dot length is 8, I value 1 and minus 1. 8 minus 2, 8 minus 2 is a 6. X of 6 is a 9. 9 is assigning to X of 1. 9 is assigning to X of 1. 9 is assigning to X of 1. Then, X of 6 is assigning with temp value. What is the temp value? Temp value is a 6. Temp value is 6. Likewise, it is continuing. If total number of elements are odd, the middle element will be remains in the middle only. If total number of elements are odd, we don't require we don't require to swap. If middle element If total number of elements are odd, assume 7 elements are there. The fourth element is a material. That doesn't require to swap. If total number of elements are 8, then here total number of elements are 8. 3 is swapping with the 12, 6 is swapping with the 9, 1 is swapping with 4, 6. 1 is swapping with 6, 10 is swapping with 4. If one more element is there in the middle, that element doesn't require to swap. It will be remains middle only even while reversing also. So we don't require to change the logic while number of elements are even or odd. No matter number of elements are even or odd. This is very important. For complex arrays related examples, we will be using majority of the times swapping. Swapping is very much required. Can see. Well, we swapping with the 3. 9 is swapping with 6. 6 is swapping with 1. 4 is swapping with 10. Even you can take one more sample in the same. By adding one more element. Let me comment first one. Total number of elements are odd. The middle element that is 4, it will be remains at the 4 only after swapping. Try to develop the same program without the temp variable. Copy the same. Z4A. I am choosing class name as Z4A. Without temp variable, try to swap. Simple mathematical calculations. Looks like a little lengthy, but it's not at all difficult. You should get the clear command on index management. As indexes are starting from zero, beginners are finding little difficulty. If indexes are starting from one, you will not be finding that much difficulty. In every programming language, array indexes are starting from zero. That is why initially you will be finding little difficulty. Once you have a clear command on index management, then it will be very simple. So move to the next one. Reverse only first half of the elements in a given array. Reverse only first half of the elements in the given array. Consider total number of arrays are even only. If you go for odd, then you have to get a condition whether middle element will be belonging to the first half or second half. That is why consider even. If at all odd is there, then you have to get a condition like whether middle element will belong to the first half or second half. Reverse only first half. I am considering a sample of 8 elements. I am not considering sample of 9 elements. First half of the elements 3, 6, 1, 10 should be reversed. 3, 6, 1, 10. We should not disturb second half of the array. Try to disturb only first half of the array. You need to reverse only first half of the array. As usually I value 0. Starting from I value 0, the last element you have to consider is length by 2 minus 1. Wherever x dot length you are using, there you can use x dot length by 2 minus 1. So length is a 8, 8 by 2 is a 4, 4 minus 1 is a 3. The last element you have to consider as a 3. In the first iteration, 0th index 1 should be swapped with a 3. 0th index 1 should be swapped with a 3. In the next index 1, in the next iteration, 6 should be swapped with 1, that is 1 index should be swapped with 2 elements. Totally 4 elements are there. Zero, 1, 2, 3. For simplification purpose, let's go for end is equal to x dot length divided by 2 minus 1. Or you can leave this minus 1. X dot length divided by 2. Now use end. Wherever x dot length is there, check it out whether it is working or not. Are you getting any exception? It's working. So Ahilya, first element was swapping with the last element. Now first element should swap from the middle. Second element, last but one from the middle. I found out end as the middle. You need to swap first element with the middle element, second element, last but one from the middle. Consider even number of elements, even number of elements. I am considering the first sample. These four elements we need to reverse. Three should be swapped with the tan. Six should be swapped with one. Six should be swapped with one. That is why n is 8 divided by 2. N is a 4. From 0th index onwards, 3 to 4 but not 4. 3 to 4 but not 4th one, 3 to 3. N is equal to x dot length divided by 2. N is a 4. Now you can observe I value 6. I value 0. If I value 0, x of 0 swapping with x of 3. End is a 4, 4 minus 0 minus 1. X of 0 swapping with x of 3. In the next iteration, I value will be 1. X of 1 swapping with 4 minus 1 minus 1. 4 minus 2, that is 2. X of 1 is swapping with x of 2. In the next iteration, I value will become a 2. 2 less than 2, false, coming away. 2 less than 2, false. If you are finding difficulty, you can use the previous approach with a temp variable. But always try to develop. Without a temp variable, if at all it is a numeric. So interviewers are expecting swapping two numeric variables, swapping two numeric values without a temp variable. So after developing 2-3 examples, you can become very comfortable. It's a simple calculation. So assume 6 and 4, you want to swap. Sum will be 10. 6 is the first variable, 4 is a second variable. Sum will be 10. First variable should be swapped with 4 means 10 minus 6. 10 minus 6. He will be getting the second variable 10 minus 4. You will be getting a 6. Only simple calculation. Second half remains the same. First half only got reversed. First half only got reversed. Second half remains the same. Second half remains the same. Reverse only last half of the elements in a given array. That is second half. So try to develop reversing second half. Copy the same program, implement only second for loop. Reverse only second half. Reversing second half. We need to reverse only second half.